Sorry, just doing some light reading. Did you know that the war in Indochina is one of the most notorious conflicts in the last century? It occurred predominantly in Vietnam, but stretched even into Cambodia and Laos. It is recognized as lasting up until 1989. But what shaped this conflict? What aspect of the world's climate caused this to play out the way it did? The answer to these questions are all in one way or another the result of the other, while also each playing a role in communism's shaping of the conflict in Indochina. The Cold War greatly influenced US ideology towards communism. As such, the US was greatly against Ho Chi Minh's political ideals and could not be seen as sanctioning his rule of Vietnam. America needed to show their hand, so the US moved into Vietnam, forever changing the Indochina conflict. The Cold War's effect on communism shaped the conflict in Indochina. After the end of World War II, a power vacuum was created across Europe, splitting half of it to communist Russia and the other half to democracy. This split created a fear throughout the Western world that communism would spread to their own nations. This fear was fueled by the anti-communist publications.
The great masses will more easily fall victims to a big lie than to a small one.
Adolf Hitler said that, and he broadcast the big lie to the world. The Hitler gang joined in. The big lie growing bigger. The Nazi voices are still now, but the big lie lives. New faces, new voices. Stalin and the Stalin gang. The big lie bigger and bigger.
Politics. And media. These two political ideologies were extremely conflicting, creating a subtle discord. This discord between the two world powers grew and is now known as the Cold War. Understandably, as communism seeped into Asia, the American populace became anxious that if war were to start, they would be confronted with a battle against the entire eastern seaboard of Asia. So the USA had to act. The domino theory was an idea created by Dwight Eisenhower that if Vietnam was to fall to communist forces, surrounding nations like Cambodia, Laos, Thailand, and more influential countries further away like India, China, and even Australia would be soon to follow. This theory became more and more common as politicians used it to emphasize the strategic importance of Vietnam.
Vietnam, the communists would control Vietnam. Pretty soon Thailand, Cambodia, Laos, Malaya would go.
If this little nation goes down the drain and can't maintain her independence, ask yourself what's going to happen to all the other little nations.
This theory was supported by John F. Kennedy when he came into power, and as such he furthered the US's investment in Vietnam. Robert McNamara stated that they needed to withdraw troops from Vietnam when talking to Kennedy himself. Unfortunately, Kennedy was not willing to commit himself to withdrawal or to an increase in the USA's presence in Vietnam. Kennedy was assassinated on 22nd of November 1963, and Lyndon B. Johnson was sworn in as the next president. There was no talk of withdrawal from LBJ, and he pledged to help Vietnam.
This nation will keep its commitments from South Vietnam to West Berlin.
As the presidents changed, so did the USA's role in Indochina, becoming increasingly militant in Vietnam. The perspective of US politicians on communism greatly shaped the Indochinese conflict. Along with the American government's inability to present themselves as sanctioning of a communist rule over Vietnam, they needed to present themselves as developing and supporting a democratic government. The USA went about this by helping South Vietnamese leaders, and much to their disbelief, found little success in their candidates, until they supported Nguyen Khan, who in many ways acted upon the will of the people. He charged generals responsible for the mistreatment of Buddhists and attempted to achieve justice for victims and society. Unfortunately, despite his early success as a leader, the political backing given by the US was too great and reduced public support for him. Yet Khan remained in power, as the South Vietnamese people started to look north for political stability. The implementation of US military support as a response to the communist presence shaped the conflict in Indochina. The American Air Force was used to supply South Vietnamese troops and help wounded. But this support was not enough to maintain a strong defense against the communists. So LBJ started to launch hit and run raids in North Vietnam. These hit and run raids provoked VC bombings of the USS Maddox. The first attack was considered to be an accident. There was also thought to be a second attack, but it was not confirmed. Until on August 4th, 1964, the US decided there was a deliberate attack on the USS Maddox and sent bombers to attack North Vietnam. LBJ admitted that in all likelihood the attacks on the Maddox were in response to the covert raids on North Vietnam, and thus began Operation Rolling Thunder, the bombing of North Vietnam. As always, this generated a strong response from the Viet Cong, and they attacked US air bases. On March 8, 1965, United States troops landed on South Vietnamese beaches in order to protect US air bases as they became more targeted. This response generated one from the VC, generating one from the US, and so on and so forth, till the US could do nothing but commit to an all-out war in Vietnam. Communism played a great role in shaping the conflict in Indochina. This is due to the Cold War's influence on US ideology towards communism. This ideology forced the US to oppose Ho Chi Minh's political ideals. This opposition affected America's influence on Vietnam politically and militarily. These political and military influences on Vietnam forever shaped the Indochinese conflict. This theory became more and more common as politicians used it to emphasize the strategic importance of Vietnam. Can I say strategic? Unfortunately, Kennedy was not willing to commit himself to withdrawal or to an increase in the USA's president in Vietnam. What? A little bit illegal in there for you, Mr. Ingold. Attempted to achieve justice for victims and society. LBJ won the election and 1 week later advises. Damn, I don't have any advisors. La 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 la, la 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 la.
Think of Christmas, think of snow, think of sleigh bells, off you go like reindeer in the sky. You can fly, you can fly, you can fly.
God bless America.